Neighbors, and welcome back to Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney. Last time we started this trial, and she really fucked us over, but I feel like we got it. I feel like I know what I need to do. I feel like... No. It's what she brought. Bam. And you witnessed this. You saw Miss Guy stab the victim with a knife. As I've already said, yes. I swear to my finest salmon swirl lunch. I'm sure that is a fine lunch. But isn't that odd? Look at this photograph! This is the photograph you took at the very moment of the crime, is it not? And why is Miss Guy not holding a knife? Edgeworth, your thoughts? Objection. That'd be the weakest objection ever, Edgeworth. It is still stronger than your ever feeble mind, Mr. Wright. What do you mean, Mr. Edgeworth? This photograph was not taken at the moment before the stabbing. It was taken at the moment after the stabbing. Objection! And how could you tell that? Well, that's flatter. See the dark crimson stains on the chief prosecutor's coat? Can we get a photo with color? I feel like that'll really help us out. It's a black and white photograph. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yes, it's hard to tell, but this could be blood. Well, Mr. Wright, I see no problem here. No problem, except you. Mr. Wright, I gotta just sit there and take that kind of abuse. Emma, can you shut up? Ugh, got a better idea. Objection. Wait. That contradicts what the witness said in her testimony. Namely, she took the picture the moment she witnessed the crime. Well, it seems I was slightly unclear. My apologies. That's it. If you run out of lunch, you order seconds. Problem solved. If you don't like it, try ordering the jumbo-sized lunch from the get-go. Good advice. I'm not sure I understood it, but good advice. It was not. That advice kinda sucked. I didn't have time to stop her. The prosecutor's guy was cold, calculated, like a robot. She killed without pain or remorse. It was a premeditated murder.
Objection!
Premeditated? How do you know? Look at the chief prosecutor's hand in the photograph. Well, they're gloves. Surgical gloves, made out of thin rubber, most likely. Why would she have those on? Didn't she have leather gloves that she always wore with her outfit? They're not premeditated. She would not be wearing those. He popped out of fucking nowhere. Back up, Edward. If it's not premeditated, she would not be wearing those gloves.
Warg.
God, I love her outfit. Sorry. These gloves do seem to be to tell a tale of premeditation. Premeditated murder. A serious offense. Witness, add this to your testimony. Murder was planned. Rubber gloves prove it. No. Because it would be... Because if it was premeditated, she would have had her own stuff. The fact that she...
Wrong one!
The fact that she didn't would mean that she would not have used Edgeworth's stuff. Because it was in the toolbox in his, trunk. Yeah. Boom! Fuck off! Witness, do you know what this is? Are you trying to test me? I sell box lunches for a living, you know. As a knife. The knife. The knife that was in Mr. Edgeworth's trunk. Indeed, it is my knife. Let's quit this case. Bloody murder weapon. Red car. belong to the prosecutor there. That Quinn is the chief prosecutor for the district, right? Well, we are prosecuted bad people. It depends. The defense has a request. Does the witness prove an accurate, or provide an accurate testimony? What's that, rookie? In your testimony, you stated that Lana Sky planned this murder. And that's why she was wearing the special gloves. Seems like a natural conclusion to me. The gloves do indicate planning.
However,
why would she not also prepare the most important thing, the murder weapon? What did I just say? Oh. Oh my. Knife just happened to be in the trunk of the car. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're gonna plan a murder, you don't forget the weapon. No, her lunches! My lady! Order! Great, now the tide is turning in our favor. Thank you, Mr. Wright. Guys, this is as good as free. Lies. Tisk. Right. I believe the next lunch you'll be eating is humble pie. This is the stupidest fucking case! This is so stupid! Why is it so dumb? They're not even clever! It hurts. Oh no! I beg, please! What? I hope you weren't deluding yourself into thinking that the tide has turned. Not over such trifling detail. It's the big. I'm actively losing brain cells. Like, actively. Like, they are gone. They are dead. Bye! But this shoots a hole in the whole premeditated theory. Bah, don't be a sheep, please, I beg. The prosecution could care less if it was premeditated or not. It's your boss. You dumb fuck, it's your boss. The only one who seems to care is that lunch lady over there. The defendant, Lana Sky, murdered a detective with a knife. That's the only thing the prosecution need prove. Nothing else. Here comes the prosecutor. I suppose you think you're clever now. Oh, she pissed. But you know as well as I do that she planned on killing him. It was planned. If it wasn't, why would she be wearing? I'd really like to hear your testimony again. Witness, please tell us only what you saw, not what you thought. How dare you? My powers of deduction are not to be underestimated. God, I love you. Really now. Witness testimony. Angel's deduction. When this guy intended to murder Detective Goodman. That's why she called the victim all the way to the prosecutor's office. I'm sure the chief prosecutor had a grudge against the victim. Nothing else would drive that human machine to plunge the knife in again and again. But it wasn't again and again. It was a single stab. Liar McGee! I used to love you. You're making my life a lot harder. Mitchell was summoned from the police department to the prosecutor's office. It does sound a lot like premeditation, doesn't it? Mr. Judge, you're not helping. If I ordered a pizza, does that mean I'm planning to kill the delivery boy? That's a good... Sure. Why not? In any case, the defense may now cross-examine the witness. Cross-examination. Angel's deduction. Like this, she is a lying, meanie bobini. Not as kind intended to murder Detective Goodman. And we are present. Hold it! You said that, but you haven't told us how you know. That's what I'm gonna tell you, rookie. I like the head on. Like it's, oh, she's so cool. I love her. She's the best. I think she was just, what she said was a mere prelude to the story she's about to tell. I'm gonna interrupt her again. Rookie. Never interrupt a storyteller. It's like pulling a bun out of the oven half-baked. People do that. And I feel like that's when you open it up to put, like, mise and stuff inside. And then you cook it the rest of the way. So that is the thing. Lunch lady! Something is half-baked here, alright. And it's you. Don't have to confuse the defense witness. They're not very quick on their feet. Thank you! I know! Now, why did you believe Tess pretended to just murder the victim? Her actions speak for themselves. So she called the victim all the way to the prosecutor's office and make her mad. You have no proof that Miss Guy called him over there. You have no proof that she didn't. Mr. Edgeworth, thoughts? There's no record of a call made on the defendant, Miss Lana Sky's phone. She might have written him a letter. Come on. I could have tried public phone first, at least. In case the victim came to the prosecutor's office, where you were murdered. I'm sure you had a reason to be there. Witness? Why do you think it was the suspect who summoned the victim that day? Yeah, we're really assuming a lot after we said we only need to know what we know, not what we thought. The chief prosecutor had a grudge against the victim. And why? What kind of grudge? Well, I wouldn't know that. Of course you don't. It's because she didn't have a grudge. Rookie. I have a lunchbox here. Now what's the side? How am I supposed to know? See? We agree that there is a lunchbox here, but we don't know what's the side. Real Schrodinger's cat situation. Which is left like a lunchbox with pretzels. Would you agree? No. No, I do not. I get it. That's why my lunch was so salty. Josh isn't very good with metaphors. Suspect had a grudge against Detective Goodman. Will you tell us your basis of thinking this? It's simple. Any of us would drive that human machine and plunge the knife in again and again. Well, see, you're wrong because, one knife wound. Where is it? Well, bam! Objection! You say she stabbed him again and again, but you couldn't have witnessed that. Are you testing me? And I'll test you. With my moss surprise. Is this just a box of grass? Oh my god. Oh, I wish I could keep a collection of all these lunchboxes. It's so fucking stupid. I'm afraid that moss is growing under our feet as we wait, Miss Star. Yeah, like the head on her being like, feck off. God, she's so cool. I could only wish. What do you mean? I shouldn't have to explain this. But take a look. The autopsy report states that the death was due to loss of blood. From one stab wound. Ah, you're right. Good show, Mr. Edgeworth. What a hunk. He's my hero, really. You're on my side, you fucking dick! Come on, my impression. No one noticed? Well, witness. Got the crime scene set, right? I don't think I want to eat that. Oh, thanks. I always believed that no one could ever mistake it for blood. Now I realize that such mistakes are possible. So, you're saying you mistook something for blood? She lifted her knife. I thought I saw blood at her breast. but a blood from her victim. That's why I thought she must have stabbed him at least twice. And tell us what you saw that you thought was blood! Testify! You dumb! Let's get this show on the road! Your muffler looked like blood to me. That's how ghastly the whole scene was. She wasn't wearing a scarf. And that's what a muffler is a type of scarf. So, no! Where is it? Miss Star, I demand an explanation. Objection. The witness is clearly not suited for detective work. What? The suspect is not wearing a scarf or muffler of any kind when she stabbed the victim. And you proved it yourself with this photograph. Huh? That can't be, no! Her lunches! A professional lunch lady could be so utterly clueless. Edgeworth! Edgeworth! Congratulations! Perhaps you finally found your true calling in life.
I love you!
Harsh words, but good! In the end, Mr. Edgeworth prevails. What was my objection, chop liver? What was there? No, not that. Something red, really. Well now, where were we? The witness has given us an entertaining interlude, but back to business. What? Please, Edgeworth, I want to keep getting lunches. Very well, witness, continue testimony. You saw the crime and apprehended the suspect. Tell us about that. Very well. I do remember something accurately, at least.
No.
Ultimately, we couldn't shake the most important part of her testimony. The most important part. The part where her sister stabbed the victim. Her testimony might just be the moment of truth. We're in a testimony apprehending the suspect. Because she already has a grudge against prosecutors. So she could just be talking out of ass. Oh. After the murder, the suspect attempted to run behind the partition off to her side. The police caught her, explaining her rights to her and arrest her on the spot. Ah yes, when I arrested her, she mentioned the muffler. That's what had me confused in my earlier testimony. Prosecutor made an escape against Angel Star, which is futile.
This whole court is...
Oh my god. You're quite determined about the scarf, aren't you? I shuck like a snake and bite like a cobra.
They're both snakes!
That's me, Angel Star. That wasn't a very good metaphor. First of all, a cobra is a kind of snake. Don't bother me with details, unless you want to get bitten. I'm gonna leave that there. No thanks. I was just gonna leave it. There itself. Mr. Wright is weak as poisonous snake bites. The chief prosecutor tried to resist, but her efforts were in vain. She dropped my hands aside, kicked over an oil drum. An oil drum? I can't imagine. Oh, she's beautiful, but deadly. A predator, this one. A leopard woman.
Rawr.
Very well, Mr. Wright, to cross-examination, if you will. Cross-examination. Apprehending the suspect. After the murder suspect attempted to run behind a partition off to her side. So where's this partition on the floor plans? I'm sure she means this wellness to the car. That's right. Very well there, about 6 feet high. She's obviously trying to hide herself. What a natural thing for a criminal to do. What would you do then? I quickly caught her. It's when I arrested her and arrested her on the spot. But how did you get around so fast? around the gate. That's where I'm having an issue. What's that, people? We're that close to suspect. Like you said, it's only 30 feet away from here the whole time. Maybe I should... let's press her for more details, because the gate blocked the thing. I'd like to see it on the floor plans, just to be safe. And which lady's car was? She was a visitor, thus she was parked at B block. So where is the murder from? Here. Maybe about 30 feet away from the car, yes. Is that correct, Miss Star? Yes, that's right. It's a chain link. Yes! That's what I was saying! I'm a psychic, that's it. But there's a chain link fence in front of you. I went over it, of course. Raising the cough of Queen. Large lady, athlete, indeed. It would take her a little time to climb over the fence. She couldn't have gotten my sister that fast. The fence was about 9 feet high, too. How did this guy not get away? When I arrested her, she mentioned the muffler. Sorry. Mentioned the muffler. What exactly did she say? I don't remember exactly. I would have told you my testimony. Shaky. Anyway, all I heard her say was the word muffler. What's that word? So, what you heard wasn't suspect talking to you, but to someone else. Yes, the chief prosecutor was talking on her phone. The phone? You can't mean. Ask further. My phone, do you mean this phone discovered at the crime scene? Yes, ultimately. Ultimately? My memory. It's like a salmon, heading upstream, you see. No, the court does not see, Miss Star. Chief Prosecutor first attempted to use the phone hanging on the wall. The wall? That's right. Near the car. There's an emergency phone on the wall. Apparently, it was out of order. So she used a cell phone. Indeed, the emergency phone was out of order that day. That's really bad. Why would the emergency phone be out of order? That's so bad. Good witness. I just heard good witness. Witnessing. I hope you're having a good testifying. You should, of course, add this to your testimony. Things I do to please the rookie defense attorney. On a cell phone, the word muffler was overheard during a call made to Emma at 5:18. Donna's cell phone updated in the court record. I saw it all. But she tried the phone on the wall, but instead had to use her cell phone instead. Do you think you could restate your testimony for the court? Ah, we can ask the same thing. I only say this one time, so listen closely, rookies. Cause how the fuck? There's so much here that doesn't make sense. She is being a lying liar. Cause there is no way she could not see the phone. The chief prosecutor stabbed the victim and ran behind the partition. She looked at the emergency phone on the wall. It was out of order. She pulled out her cell phone out of her pocket. Yeah. And during that time, she climbed over the chain link fence. Then, when I pulled the grabbed her arm, the prosecutor hung up her phone. And you saw her doing this. What is it, Mr. Wright? I see. I smell it's cooking because... No, you did not. So sorry. I keep coughing. Miss Star, I have to conclude that you have a personal grudge against Vislana Sky. Objection! The witness is a former detective. Her testimony is unmarred by personal bias. Well, who would have thought you would be my knight in shining armor, prosecutor? You, who worked together with the chief prosecutor, he could be out 2 years ago. Well, Miss Star, there's a fatal contradiction to your testimony. How do you explain this? I don't know what you're talking about. Mess with me, and I'll make you cough it all up. It just sounds like you're being physically sick. It's gross. What's with the floor plans? Is anyone else a crime from this point? However, if that's true, you could possibly have seen Miss Guy making that phone call. I believe you see where I'm getting at. My emergency phone is on the back side of this partition. If indeed you were in Block B, you couldn't have seen it. What? She's losing so many lunches. Order, order. What's the meaning of this? It's simple, Your Honor. She's not coughing up lunch. She's coughing up lies.
She's gurring. Oh my.
It's quite a play, Mr. Wright. Perhaps you will allow me a question. That's exactly what lie the witness has told the court. So that the counterattack begins, I can't afford to get this wrong. The witness lied about what she saw. She lied about what she saw. In other words, she didn't see this guy using the emergency phone. It seemed hard to imagine how she could have. Very logical. What's the matter, Star? Can I got your lunchbox? This is so stupid. Mr. Wright, I hate to bother you while you're celebrating your victory. Why would Miss Star lie like that? Why would she say that my sister tried to use the phone but failed? Doesn't make any sense. Why lie about something so insignificant? Dang, she's right. I mean, maybe she really did try... see her try to use the emergency phone. I see no room for doubt here. You ordered the patouille on a ride, right? The patouille! Oh, no. Okay, well, R.I.P. Mr. Wright, I thought you had something in there. One more try. I see it in your eyes. You haven't learned your lesson, have you? That's exactly what lie the witness has told the court. Maybe she was in the security room because of his boyfriend number one. That may be why she saw it. This guy tried to use the emergency phone, but it was out of order. What is significant about this fact? Nothing. Before we become this woman, start a lie about it. Well, it's a lie, I see. I see the victim did actually see this guy using the emergency phone. That would mean you started to witness the crime from a different location. A different location? Now that's a pointless lie if I've ever heard one. Before you call my lie pointless, at least let me tell it. Let me ask a question to our clever wordsmith, Mr. Wright. Just where was the witness when she saw the crime? All the testimony we've heard until now points in one direction. The place where Miss Guy witnessed this crime was here.
Take that!
This is the only place where she could have done that. Security guard room. Indeed, the security guard room is an underground parking lot, is well positioned. It's built on the second floor, so you can see the entire lot. She would have been able to see the emergency phone from there. But why there? There are many other places where she could have seen the phone. Not in this case, Your Honor. The witness not being part of the prosecutor's office couldn't park in A block. The only place where she could have seen the crime is the back of the partition. And the back of the partition is there. I remember in your testimony you said you brought a lunch to your boyfriend in the security guard room, yes? Well, Miss Star.
She ain't.
many years have I been getting the better of men? To think that the tables could be turned. Today, a man had got the better of Angel Stone. Order, order. Witness. What have you done? You used to be a detective, you should know better. I'm not turning back. The guilty will be punished. And I'll do what I must to make sure that justice prevails. Guilty. Talking about a sky. Is it right? This tricky was odd. Why did this star lie? It doesn't make any sense. You could have just said she saw the crowd at the security guard station. I'm gonna change anything. Exactly. Switchgraph tells all. The defendant who stabbed the victim. She still stands. It still stands. I disagree, Mr. Edgeworth. What? If the witness is found to be lying, they're guilty of perjury. She knows this. She wouldn't risk that without good reason. And tell us what her reason was, Mr. Wright. Me? Who else? Mr. Wright, let's review what we know. Mr. witnessed the crime from the security guard station. She lied and said that she saw it in B-Block. See a vital difference, but what? It could change. This, yes, but I think the more important one is this. Because she was closer. Kind of. It changes the distance between her and the scene of the crime. My condolences, Mr. Wright. But one look at the floor plans and it's quite clear. The distance between the scene of the crime and the guard station is 30 feet. I don't see how that could change what she could see. She has to go down and around. What she saw is not a question here. What matters is the time it would take her to reach the scene of the crime. Miss Star, you witnessed the crime for the security guard station. Now, how long did it take you to get there? To the scene of the crime where you arrested Miss Sky. Well, witness? You. Yeah? You ordered squid wheels, right? That sounds awful. The quality of my lunches has gone from low to inedible. I was bringing a PB&J lunch with fresh boysenberry jam to my boyfriend. Blueberries are nice. Boysenberry for the boyfriend. For the station, so I waited. I went to craft the glass wall station. Before I knew what I was doing, I found myself running toward the scene. But the door was locked. Couldn't open it. That's why I had to go through the visitor's parking in Block B. It's quite the detour. Probably took me at least 5 minutes to get to the scene of the crime. A contradiction! Because he said that the phone call happened at 5:18. So she would have had to be there by 5:18 to stop the call. Now I don't trust it. 5 minutes. Changes things considerably. But it was that woman over there and the defendant's chair who stabbed him. I know it. I have photographic evidence. I swear it. I swear it on my finest plastic spork. You have a point. And the spork is a wonderful invention. Would you like another caviar lunch? Absolutely. Uh-oh. So right, you have to do something. Do you have any evidence to stop this? I'm gonna end this episode here, because it's taking me a little longer than I thought it would. But I feel like we're getting her. So, thank you very much for watching, and hopefully, I will see you later.